light pole here. We're going to be moving him out of the pathway over there on that thing.
Uh-huh.
The problem we have is we just don't have enough materials to work with.
If you had some more materials, yep.
Yeah, I was hitting the ODOT folks up because they have all these dumpsters
on our way down.
Just full of all the materials that we could use. We're busting up pallets now just to get
How many people are living back in this little section?
Altogether?
One.
Right back up in
four.
Here. About four people?
Four or five.
Nice shaded trees and.
Yeah, we're growing. You know, out to where it's all above ground, the walkway, everything, because when the rain comes, you know, it's muddy and water.
So you made all these shelters with pallets?
I've made them all with pellets, yeah.
Everything.
That's pretty creative there.
If we had just come up even and more supplies, we could go so much quicker and so much quicker.
Careful here, there might be some more than nails.
All right.
This is empty. I wanted to make a barbecue out of. I just took the tent down yesterday.
Yeah, a little tent up in here.
It was a tent, but I've made a, basically a...
Oh, a little, yeah, this is nice.
All out of pallets and wood and stuff that's donated. And it's coming along, it's working, we're going to do more today.
Propane,
yeah.
Yep.
We try to make so that we're safe with what we're doing up here.
That's what's important, to be safe.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of what you need, so I have first aid kit, I have, where did it go? I have an AED, pretty much has Ortec, and readily available stuff that if we do need it, we can address the issue.
Cool.
Like I said, our goal is to, like this here, bring this out. The entire area is going to be off the ground.
A little platform-like. Uh-huh.
Build another one here, and I'm going to bring this all the way down out front.
Is this a private property, then, that we're on right now? Have you met and talked with those people much at all?
We try to figure out who actually is owner of the property. From what I understand, OSL owns a port, ODOT owns a portion and whatnot. The actual property we're on, the house itself owns it, from what I understand. I might be incorrect, but that's what I've heard. I just know we're on private property.
And they haven't been really down here bugging you, though, have they?
We haven't. Not one person said anything about it.
Cool.
We try to keep, quiet and...
I never even knew this was down here, and I drove by a couple times. I still almost couldn't even find it. So
the fire department yesterday came out because they were using the open fire down there. And the fire department didn't even know it was here.
Uh-huh.
Like, where are you at? We're up there. Where?
Were they saying no open fire?
No open fire, no.
Barbecue or propane?
Yes. They really don't want briskets or charcoals either.
Propane almost.
Propane mainly. It's so easy for them to start a fire.
Yep, I agree.
Accidents happen.
I noticed you guys got a shovel there for... emergencies.
I've got a few shovels.
We got fire extinguisher. We got
fire extinguisher, shovels, AED, first aid kits.
We try to plan for any eventuality.
Cool.
Again, every single bit of what you see out here was either given or donated. It's amazing what you find when you look or you ask.
Right.
Just ask. We come up with so much just by asking.
Mm-hmm.
I do a lot of that. I'll go to businesses, I'll talk to them, I'll tell them what's going on, and just ask them. And a lot of times they say,
donate and help out, yeah. That's all it takes a lot of times.
Yep.
So if we can make a go of this, it gives us more legitimacy to go ask people for stuff, and there'll be a whole lot more willing to help. Now it's like, okay, what's your game,
So, roundabout estimate, how many pallets do you guys need?
They want to do a whole fence around here, don't they?
The fence, the models are probably about 100.
About 100.
Decent size. But the ones built like this are the best to get. And the ones that come with just like the beam underneath, the thicker ones. Mm-hmm. I make do with whatever I can find. But obviously I look for the heavier duty or better built ones because I break them apart.
Right.
And go from there.
Half the time they're giving these away too, if you just had a ways and means to get to them, huh?
Mississippi stop, side of the building, they put them out there for people to take.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of businesses want them gone because they can't do anything with them.
Yeah.
And then they got to pay to have them removed, so they want them gone. And
if
along with the pallets.
One person with a pickup truck that was willing to just donate maybe an hour or two, we could, because he spends all night long trying to pick up stuff off the side of the road. And he can only pull so much.
I'll pull in my trailer, I'll pull, you know, 7-8 pallets at a time. Mm-hmm. Trailers. It's hard work, but.
So what you guys need is someone with a pickup truck to donate time
and
gas.
Be great to,
basically, yeah.
We could move so much more stuff.
And you know, if you go around the neighborhood, it's free boxes. People set stuff out on the side of their curb that you end up going in the dump, get wasted or whatnot, and their things, you know. For instance, like cooking supplies, pots and pans, and I mean, just all kinds of things that end up in the garbage. They're all useful. Right.
See what people throw away, it's stunning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's abusive.
Resourceful, I mean, yeah. The person can survive, it's fine.
When I heard that there's going to be an eviction today, was this camp right here part of that eviction?
No, as far as we know, no.
Uh-huh. It was more the lower stuff and maybe at the far...
That's ODOT property out there, and this is like, I think this is Osol.
This is part of the garden. They call it the garden.
Is there a conflict with the little groups or the people on the one land with the other land? You guys all kind of working together a little bit?
Actually, if anything, we've tried to help them out.
We do our best. The problem we run into, and I think you run into it everywhere, is the addiction to drugs and whatnot, and you get the different problems that come along with it. Everybody's got issues. I'm a recovering addict myself, too, so I completely understand, but everybody's at a different stage and they're different levels, so that's the problem we run into, is keeping it separate. It's never going to go away.
No.
But that's the issue we run into.
Stuff doesn't seem to be walking off from the camp at all. Like, this first time since I've been here, I've been able to put my stuff down and walk away.
That's good.
Granted, we always leave someone here.
Yeah.
Even though it's right around close by, but...
I think we got to do that all over, even
we do.
Everywhere.
Whether it's your house, your family, yeah. What you do.
Yeah. Yeah. Unfortunate.
But.
What's that?
That's an old picture right there. Him and his fatigue standing by his house. It is.
Yeah. Classic.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for showing us.
Yeah. I love things like this because it shows creativity. It shows that people, even though they're down on their luck, aren't just giving up, but are willing to stand up and say, "Hey, I'm going to make a shelter. I'm going to make a good place. I'm going to respect myself."
We've actually gone beyond that. We're sheltering ourselves, but we're also trying to help others at the same time.
Right.
That's what we're trying to do.
Love it. It's good.
There's those that you can't help at the moment. You know, they're not in that stage in their life where they're ready for the help. But
right.
Those we're want actually to. The best ones to actually determine who's like too far gone to really commit to a community-based operation. Or
right.
Somebody that's willing to consider giving up their craft just for the sake of safety and community.
Right.
Yeah. Sounds
I
good.
I enjoy it anyway.
Okay. Keep it up and
we're trying.
Let's make it work. And he's in town talking with the mayor or something, right?
I think so.
Yeah. Which he might have some good info when he comes back, I hear. That's what I hear.
He always does. You know, guys, to give it a little inch further with each individual person, you start adding those inches together. So we're at the kind of communal living room. This is where everybody coming through gathers. We have 9, 10, 12 people here all sitting around in the evening, if we can.
All right.
Even like, if we could get chairs, just chairs for everybody.
Uh-huh. Some little basic comforts, you know, not asking for a lot, but...
We're sawing wood up here with the damn drywall saw.
Uh-huh.
So trying to build anything out of these old hard pallets is really interesting.
Fourth.
That's my house.
Nice.
Right. Fourth Estate, I like that.
Well, they call the media the Fourth Estate now, but originally the Fourth Estate was anybody outside of any kind of structured society. That was originally the Fourth Estate, which is now the Fifth Estate. The media has taken over the Fourth Estate.
That's sad right there.
Nice view too, kind of, you know, up on the hill.
That guy right there is one of the most ingenious characters. See that long thing he's got laid out there?
Yeah.
That was his trailer. He toted that thing around with a bicycle. He had like 17 batteries on that thing one time.
Wow.
Yeah. If you ever looked at him without his clothes on, which I've seen him a number of times, that man is built better than anybody up here from all the crap that he totes on that trailer.
Mm-hmm.
He'll go get 12-foot-long 4x4s and load that trailer and bring them up here. Just stuff he finds all over.
He's creative in the ways and means on how he's figured that out.
Watching him build that trailer, everybody said, you're crazy, man. That thing's way too heavy, but it got it balanced perfectly to where there was no weight on his bike. And he's always busy doing stuff. You know, I mean, somebody like that, if you can channel that energy to doing something for the group.
So how long is that bike trailer thing?
15 foot, easy.
And none of that puts the weight on the bicycle?
Well, it depends on where you put your axle.
Yeah.
If you have your axle in the right location, it takes all the weight off of the tongue. You've got zero weight on the tongue.
Right.
Now all the weight is on the trailer, so you can just pull.
That's cool.
And each individual one has their own individual story. So,
mm-hmm.
Depending on how I get it.
Did you see the police come up and, from up your vantage point up here, see them down there milling around?
When we walked through here to set out the notices, we watched all that. They were very friendly when they did that. They didn't want any hassle. It's right. Going to come later so they can come put their signs
here just to let
out.
You know, here's our sign. Okay.
We don't know anything. We're just told to put signs up. Y'all have a nice day. Get out of here.
Yeah.
That's the gentleman, I think, from that's offered all of them a place to live down the street.
Oh, one of these guys is here? The guy with the bag?
Yeah, I believe so.
He's the one that's, what, got property or the idea?
It's another group that when they heard about these people being kicked out, they came yesterday and offered them, if they do get kicked out, we have a place for you to go down there. So,
a little further out, but it's a place.
It's safe. Believe me, people will travel miles for safety.
Mm-hmm.
They will.
Yeah.
In other cities, they've had success with working with the homeless. What they did is all of the resources that were in town, they moved all the resources outside of town. It did away with all the homeless downtown.
Mm-hmm. See, you keep hearing about all the resources are here, so keep the camps close so you can use the resources.
They just opened up a new train line with all kinds of, if you want to solve the pissing downtown and all that simple stuff that people are most up in arms about, get all the resources out of town. There's no reason for anybody to go hang downtown because all the resources are out of town. It worked in other cities. It's not. I'm not a smart guy. I've just seen it work in other cities.
Yeah. Yeah, Joe, anybody was telling me about when he, where was that at?
In Caracas, Venezuela. I went down there and heard a little bit about how they're doing socialism and helping the communities, and they make these small circles that in your own small circle all over the city as small circles, whatever your needs are, you petition the government and then they help you. It could be you need a sidewalk, a tree's gonna fall, your plumbing's bad, and the lowest ones get served first, not the richest guy that wants a third toilet. And so they petition the government and the government helps them, supports whatever the little circles need.
So much more cost effective to do it at that level than it is to let it go to this. Mm-hmm. So much more cost effective.
And then use resources just to push back against people who have great ideas, who can make things happen. These pallets are going in dumpsters. You guys can build little homes for people.
Mm-hmm.
But if they got laws that say you can't and they pay cops $70 an hour to come out and tell you can't, fill up dumpsters full of all your stuff when all you needed was a dumpster to just throw some trash in like we all need.
That's all.
Mm-hmm.
They need to really revamp things. How another thing Caracas was doing was taking empty buildings, and if it sat there dormant for a year or two, these groups would petition and they would get it. They would show that the building was empty and that they can move in and give people housing, give people little places to sell their wares. And we went into one. It was a dilapidated old building, but people were living in it and they were slowly fixing up with government support. And then they pointed over their shoulder and said, see that one? If you guys would stay one more week, we're taking that one next Monday. And we've already got the paperwork. The government comes in and pays the man off who owns it. because he's not using it for the community's benefit. And the people now own it.
What they've been doing here for the last 40, 50, 60 years, and it's very obvious because I can walk up here and I see fencing where they tried to homeless proof this place 20, 30 years ago because they don't use that ornamental decorative fencing anymore. And it's all over everywhere. You can't homeless proof anything. I see 10-foot, 8-foot fences with all this ornamental crap. So this problem has been going on here for a long time. And it keeps going back and forth between we go after them, we let them stay. We go after them, we let them stay. Everybody should be able to agree that what we're doing is not working. Let's try something else. Throw shit at the wall and see what it sticks. And go from there. That's what we're trying to do.
Yeah.
Our own little pile. You know?
And if you're doing it in a positive way and showing good examples, that's all going to help push this.
I want to build a better construction. You see, they're just tossed up on pallets.
Yeah.
I want to make level platforms. I want to be able to create something that can be easy. If this is a go and we can get another piece of property to do this with, I want
to have some ideas to work with now.
Just have standard platforms for everybody that we can just go
and... Hey, the right tools and enough of them, you could probably do this.
Very quickly. We could set up a camp very quickly.
Yeah, cool.
The thing to do is practice here, set up a camp here, and get all the kinks all worked out of it. And then next time if we get another piece of land, oh yeah, we know exactly what to do. Everybody knows their job. We just go set it up, and we could probably set it up for 5-6 people right away.
Who's this character?
It's terrible.
Yeah. The guys down here love me. Mm-hmm. And
hello.
They saw me slipping down here, so they got stuck.
Hey.
Andre Lou.
Thanks. I'm Vahid.
Lily. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet
you. Your name is what?
Vahid.
Vahid. Yeah. I'm Joe Anybody.
Hi, Joe.
Hi. This is Bob.
We're trying to help us out.
Good, good. Yeah. Come on in. Okay. Yeah. So is this
home?
This is home. Is this part of the Heights?
This is part of the garden.
The garden. Okay, gotcha.
I'm not sure where all the property lines are. Right. Belongs to one. Don't really care one way or the other. Just a place to hang out.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah, I just talked to the mayor this morning about y'all, and he doesn't want to. Kick everybody out either. We're trying to find solutions here.
I think we all of us are trying to, you know, we're all throwing shit against the wall and see what sticks.
Yeah. I just missed a call from Raven and a call back.
Okay.
That's his house, by the way, right there.
Okay. Cool. I think Raven has a, is that a doctor's appointment? But...
Is that who we spoke with earlier, Raven?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he said you were in talking with the mayor, I think, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And after you make that phone call, you maybe can tell us a little bit about what the mayor said?
Okay, sure.
Good, 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 good.
Okay, so.
Yeah.
I met with, the mayor came to Posey's Cafe over in Kenton neighborhood to meet with the public and on his way.
Bright and early.
Bright and early, biking to work with his public information officer, Sarah. And it was me and Sarah Long and Sam from the Greeley Garden, Samuel. Basically, it was the three of us and the mayor for the first half an hour. The whole 45 minutes, it was all homelessness. We just talked homelessness with the mayor for the whole time. At the very end, we talked a little bit about Teresa Rayford, who's an activist with Don't Shoot Portland.
I'm familiar.
Was arrested, and the charges were not dropped. And so I asked the mayor about that, and you know, would the city drop those charges. He said that Josh Alpert, his chief of staff, is talking to the district attorney about it. So, with regard to our conversation about houselessness, I asked him first if he could, you know, what's to stop the city from working with ODOT to do a moratorium on the sweeps until the city can get its emergency, state of emergency in place. This October, they're going to talk about it on the 7th in council. Once, if he could get the emergency in place and relax the zoning codes, which is what they want to do, identify temporary shelter space, and then if people need to be moved from ODOT property, they can be moved to places that the city has identified. So I said, why not a moratorium on sweeps until you do that process? And he said, that's not a crazy idea, and you know, wrote it down. So put that bug in his ear. With regard to the Greeley Camp and Hazelnut Grove, you know, I just sort of gave him the details, reminded him of the details, what have you, about what's going on here, and that the Hazelnut Grove and Osal have a meeting with Fritz later in this month, with Amanda Fritz, that this is a camp that works, and it, you know, the city should work with the folks here on seeing if this can be made to a permanent place, if more of the land can be donated, if the ODOT land can be bought by the city and donated. So they're aware, he's aware that's going on, and that Hazelnut Grove is in contact with the city, and so that was good. On the substantive issues, he did mention Israel Byers' editorial in Street Roots and said there's a lot of great ideas that are out there. So he's aware of our demands. Although when I asked him about, you know, so I said top of the list is we're saying stop the sweeps, and he heard that loud and clear, and said, you know, was making noises that was something that the city was going to look into. Down the line, you know, moratorium on no-cause evictions. And rent control could get no commitment or really any even an opinion from him, other than to say that was Saltzman's looking at that, and the city attorney's looking into the rent control issues. Mm-hmm. But so on the concrete demands from the housing advocacy community, still no nothing, not really. But it was a positive thing overall. There's a lot of media focusing on this this camp. And the city is in a difficult position. They're declaring a state of emergency with housing. To go forward with really aggressively sweeping this camp would be sort of impossible for them right now politically. So that's good.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to try to work with people down here about moving to an alternate site off of the Hazelnut Flats. Because as far as I know, ODOT is still planning to sweep it this week. So what they've told me is that they are going to do it by the 3rd. But not today. They're delaying it today to send a survey team to look at the property lines.
The proposed new property. The looking at the property here.
Yeah.
Still looking at the property, analyzing the situation.
Yeah, because if you look at the map and like the tax codes and who owns what, it's really complicated. This land is a patchwork of weird ownership. Some of it's OSALT land, right? Some of it's donated from the county. Some of it's ODOT land in weird ways. There's like a road through here that doesn't exist that is an ODOT road. There's a clear channel. You know, the billboard owners own some of the land around their billboards. Part of it is owned by city water.
Well, maybe this is all to everybody's benefit, too.
Yeah.
Because it's not cut and dry one
right.
person.
It is. Yeah.
The more muddled it becomes, the easier it is to hang on.
Yeah, right.
The mayor's never seemed too proactive with homeless issues, running people away off of City Hall, doing all these sweeps. Does it seem like right now he's sort of listening?
Yeah, what's up?
Yeah, it seems like he's listening more than in the past, definitely. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because I don't hold much hope for him. I'm just like, God, he's not done anything.
Right.
So, but now we're hearing he's meeting with some people, the state of emergency.
Yep.
These things sound positive.
Yeah. And so there's going to be, you know, on October 7th, the council will consider the proposal to declare a state of emergency and then start talking about what they can do once they've done that, moving in terms of, because of zoning, most of the places where people could shelter in the city, they can't legally shelter. And so that is a sort of a no-brainer.
Big hurdle.
Yeah. If the city can just, like, give itself the authority, which it can do under a state of emergency, to sort of play with the zoning, then they can say, yes, people can shelter here. And that's something that they're trying to do. You know, the concrete demands from the advocacy community about no-cause evictions and rent increases and rent control, we're not getting this. We're not getting enough, you know, from the city that they're hearing that. Yes, housing first. We need to deal with sheltering the people in the street. But the houseless community is growing because of no-cause evictions and because of the housing crisis and the rent crisis. So just focusing on the people on the street without addressing the pipeline of people to the street is not enough. So we really want the city to say, yes, we hear you, that, okay, great, relax the zoning codes, make shelter available for people to use. But if that's the only thing, then they're just moving more people from rent-paying spaces that they can't afford and they're getting kicked out into, you know, emergency temporary shelter. That's not a solution.
my name's Billy, and I appreciate you swinging the hammer.
That's great. See, he's getting arrested and taken to this ER, and, you know, so that needs to change.
Right? Yeah.
I mean, the city's relationship with the homeless shouldn't primarily be through the police, right? It should be through social service provision and working on making shelter available, not on sweeping people.
And especially with the DOJ, where they're here now looking at how we treat mentally people with mental problems.
Yeah.
A lot of people on the streets have that.
Yeah,
and having the police engaging with them in a negative way is not helping them, us, the community, or anybody, right?
Right. No, it's not. Yeah.
And if you guys see anything that you think needs to be corrected from a visual standpoint, we're going to be bringing people here, showing them things.
Cool.
Let me know. Let me know what needs to be cleaned up, straightened up. You know, we want this to work very badly. So anything anybody can do to help us make this work.
Well, what I see not up here but down there is you got three different areas where there's garbage bags, and two of them the garbage bags are open.
We had a dumpster of stuff. I could actually go down there, and those people would throw their stuff in the dumpster instead of island.
Right.
I remember from Occupy, there was dumpsters and toilets and running water, and slowly they shut down the services.
Right.
You know what happens? It just built up, and then it was real easy to send the corporate media down there and point at toiletry stuff in a bucket and just make the biggest deal about it.
So, snapping pictures of the garbage and make a case for the dumpsters.
But maybe more advocacy, or if they could tap into somebody who could be an advocate to help with dumpsters and sanitation.
Right.
In the city, you would think might be a good person to start with, but how they are, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Will they provide a dumpster or a toilet?
Right. Yeah, and that's something that I should ask the mayor, should ask the city.
Simple little things to help with sanitation, you know?
Yeah.
A dumpster and a porta potty would be like heaven.
Right.
And maybe other ways of handshaking with these companies that have those items to help be a sponsor, to help put their human rights first, or to try to network and shake hands and say, how can we help?
Right. That's a good idea.
Nike and Adidas are missing a golden opportunity right now. All these people, you watch their bikes, you watch the equipment, how they rig it all up. They could make a homeless-proof line of all this stuff that's particularly... it would be far better than any camping gear, because it would be designed to take the rugged daily abuse of somebody, and they have a whole treasure trove of people. Just give them their stuff and say, try it out, and let us look at it. Let's have it back in 6 months and see what...
And the nice thing about putting a porta potty down there is that when bicyclists and stuff go down, if they need to use a bathroom, there's one there.
They could parlay into it too. It's a thing where there's some bicyclists, and the whole biking thing kind of helps with.
There are just
lots of good ideas.
There are so many more good ideas if you talk to individual people. Everybody has their line, but there's always that one nugget in there. If you can just pick up that one nugget and have a whole flow of those kind of nuggets, you'll have solutions to these kind of problems.
Mm-hmm.
Right here.
Well, thanks for what you're all doing up here we're helping out.
And it would be much easier if we just had basic shit to work with, it'd be so much easier. We could help more people. We could put more people in the same.
Maybe touching base with other groups around and networking with them a little bit through some,
And what I've only been here for 3 months, and what I've seen, it just blows my mind compared to South Carolina, where I'm from.
Mm-hmm.
In South Carolina, you get a bus ticket to go to Texas if you get caught doing anything on the street. They charge you with indecent exposure, and they have an open charge. You can take the bus ticket or take the charge. Everybody takes the bus ticket and goes.
How do you get a decent exposure? Taking a leak on the side of the road?
Peeing out.
I think I got a mosey on, but I appreciate you guys all showing and sharing.
I appreciate anything. You got any more questions? You want any more? I can, if you're looking for a good story beyond that.
I'll be following up and just kind of trying to put a lens on it.
And I appreciate all of you trying to help out very much, really.
Good. Thank you.
And anything else I can do?
City of Portland.